tank of water. And into that tank of water, I'm just putting some test tubes. Fill in with water first. Yeah, bubbles. The reason for that is we're going to make something. We're going to make something in here. It's going to come out of the gas. We're going to catch it in a tube. When the tube's full, it means it's empty. When it's empty, it means it's full. When it's full, it's empty. When it's empty, it's full.
Oh, yeah, I guess that.
When it's full of water, there's no gas in it.
All right.
When it looks empty, it's full of gas. So, when it's full, it's empty.
When it's empty, it's full.
So, in here, in this tube, first thing I'm going to do is put in a bit of this fluffy stuff. Rock seal wool, it's the sort of stuff they use for insulation, yeah. And you should never touch it with your fingers.
So I didn't touch it with you.
I didn't. Where's your evidence?
Okay.
Oh no, I forgot about that. This is paraffin. Paraffin is a sort of oil. And I'm going to pour the paraffin onto the fluffy stuff. So hopefully it'll soak in, and it means we can tip it sideways without the paraffin running all over the table and causing more of a mess than normal. So, paraffin in there, get it all to soak in. I'm still with this pencil. There we go. Pour a bit of it out. And then this is just a piece of broken pot. And it's going to act as a catalyst. Now, have you come across the word catalyst before?
Yeah.
Yes, but you're not quite sure what it is. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah.
All a catalyst does is make a chemical reaction happen faster. So if I use a catalyst in this, something will happen. If I don't use it, nothing will happen. What I've got to do is really, really tricky now. I've got to heat that bit and that bit with the same Bunsen, catch the gas that comes out, swap the test tubes without knocking them over, and keep you lot occupied. Yeah. So, once I start, I have to keep going. The first thing you're going to see is bubbles because the gas is inside, the normal air expands. I'm not bothered about that. I'm only bothered when it starts reacting. So, heat it up. You can see the gas bubbles already.
Bubbles!
Got it, yeah. And we should see it starting to cloud up inside. The bubbles are slowing down, so that means the air's finished expanding. Now they've started up again, so I'm gonna catch these bubbles. What? You're making up your own stories again, aren't you? This couple go for a meal in a restaurant, and they get this big dish on the table with a lid on it. Well, I'm not telling you anymore. Is that full yet?
Yeah.
Can I
turn the
full?
No.
I'm really interested.
You didn't tell us when it's finished.
Because I've got to concentrate on this.
It's not complete.
What's round and tastes like pizza?
Pizza!
Oh, you've heard it.
So, what were you talking about the
purple? What's blue and smells like yellow paint?
Blue
paint. I'm just too good at this. You are getting me into loads of trouble at home, you lot.
Why?
My daughter is now convinced that science has to have things exploding. We don't do proper science, Daddy. It never blows up. Mine doesn't always blow up. Yes, it does.
All the bubbles come
try one more. Now I can see, yeah, this is really taking your attention. Oh look, shiny thing! It's gonna go bang any minute now. There's all sorts of safety devices we can fit, but it makes it less exciting. What do you mean, is that possible? Here we go, come on. Nearly there. So what I do now is I move that out of the way, turn that off, and hopefully, well, off it out the way, and in the water. Hopefully what we've got now is what we need for the next bit. That was just air. Right. Ugh. So this tube, we've got the paraffin we started with. These two tubes, we've got the gas we think we've produced. This one is just air. This is bromine water. You're going to see it again later on, but it can be used to test for something. We're going to use this to test to see if what we started with and what we ended up with is the same. So all I'm going to do is take some bromine water and first of all add it to the paraffin at the start. Give it a shake. And what colour is it?
Orange.
Has it changed colour?
No.
What you will see is it'll split up and you will get two layers. But basically, it's just bromine water as it is. Let's take one of these tubes. Again, add the bromine water. See if it works. If not, I'll try the other one. And if that doesn't work, I'll lie to you. No, it hasn't. This is transparent.
It's gone clear.
Colourless.
Colourless.
It's gone colourless.
Colourless.
So we have made a completely different substance. We've made air. Because if I do the same with this one, we will see air makes it go colourless as well. Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
No. So, what two bits of information can we get from this little experiment? I don't want you to tell me, I want you to write it down.